Get chat up here. All right. It's actually decent XP to kill those now. It only takes one hit. Explored that cave yet? Oh, what's this? I've definitely not been over here. Probably a doll location, I think. Bag. 500. Hi, Hugo. I'm all right. Wrong spell. Oh. XP is nice, but a little disappointing. I was kind of hoping for an upgrade or something. There should be some goodies in the next area. There should be some dolls hidden around here somewhere. Yeesh. This is something. Thank you. Fuck. God, there's so many of them. Don't remember it being that crazy with the enemy spam. I wonder if Redux tweaked that at all. It's like they wait until you go to make a jump and then they come up under you. Perfect. Could you stop throwing encounters at me for 5 minutes? Okay, not the spell I meant to use, but it'll do. They can throw them up. I did not know that. I was curious, like, wait a minute, what if I can just walk across? Bullshit area. Alright. Oh, this is definitely a spot with a doll. Man, they definitely upped the encounter rate. Oh, what's this? Oh, another encounter. That's not what I wanted. I wanted to heal. Come on, give me an upgrade. This is where the hidden village is. Yeah. I'm not gonna get 2 seconds to search, though, because the enemies are just rapid fire. God! There it is. Yeah, nothing you say could convince me that, they didn't up the spawn count timer. And fled from Kasuto when the minions of Ganon attacked. I'm not trying to talk to you. Yeah, I don't remember it being that bad. There's a secret on the outskirts of town. Three, four, five, six, seven. I think I have full magic now. Yeah, there's like a weird blue bar under my heart, so that's strange. Won't you come in? Wait, what'd she say? Something tells me that wasn't the original text, and she's gonna make- it was gonna be a lewd joke or something. Is that spell? I think I have all the spells now. Enigma. I changed it. Yeah, originally it was just called Spell. Oh, it's cheaper now. It should be. Fuck yeah. Don't have to worry about keys anymore. All these flickering townsfolk. That's right, I get the thunder spell from the original Kasuto. Yeah, you need that to fight the Thunderbird. Wait, really? Oh! It changes their XP to bots too, though. Hmm. It does only cost 12, though. That'll be really handy when dealing with Once I have my, levels filled out, it'll be really handy for getting past tough enemies. So I'll have to remember that. This is where I fight the dragon. Help! Help! I've never seen that happen before. This is what happens when an unstoppable force meets an unmovable object. Don't worry about keys anymore. Oh right, I need Reflect to kill these guys. Wrong spell, jackass. You did it again. Item here is a mirror. Yeah, it is. And it lets you see the invisible enemies in the original Kasudo. I don't believe it's required. You could just luck your way through Kasudo. on, back up. There's a pitfall in here, I think. I think it's after this one. Whoa, whoa, what? Oh, mini boss. I'm gonna fight the horse dude again. I'm not gonna survive this encounter. Yeah, I don't even have enough to cast shield. Once he turns into a blue knight, I'm pretty much toast. Assuming I don't screw up and die before then. Okay. Well, this isn't good. A key I don't need. Goody. Yeah, this is a pretty shitty tile set. Got the Book of Midora, I believe it's called. I know that's what it's called in Link to the Past. That's right, NES Zelda, they just called it the Bible. Oh well. I'm gonna level up now. Now that I think of it, I should have taken that level up, and then beating Volvagia would have gotten me the last level up. Yeah, I think this mod actually... Well, it gives you, like, a way to... Hang on, let me look it up. There's actually a way to force level up, so I can't remember how, though. Zelda to Redux. It's something the Redux mod adds. You hit, like, a little button combo. Whenever a spell, blah blah blah. Ah, here we go. Completely revamped XP system. The system makes it so you no longer get the level up window prompt once you want to level up. Oh, I didn't install that though. I don't think. so I can't do it. Wait a minute. This is where I just was, isn't it? And then there's the pit here. Yep, okay, I'm going in a circle. I need to figure out where I'm going. I just have to go left from. Obviously, because that's the only way to go that isn't in this loop. Just gonna get it back up there and go left, I guess. So I should probably heal. There's a lot of wizard shit afoot in here. I'm gonna get some XP off of these guys. What about down here? Here we go, this is new. Another 900 XP to go. Okay, this is the loop area. Yeah, okay, here's the top again. This is probably the way to the boss. Oh, fuck you. Fucking wavy enemies. Oh, that was a pathetic jump. Come on, Link. At least if I game over, I know it's not too far from the start. Wow, two of them. Blow it out your ass. Yeah, that's true. That's it. I actually died on purpose so I could level. Just grinding, guys. Pro gamer. I'm gonna give you all the tips and strats. Why is he gonna back away from me and then fall off the cliff? Just come at me, dude. Bitch ass knight. Alright. This guy's gonna fall off the map again. What the fuck are these movement patterns, really? Horrible enemy. Die. Yeah, I'm pretty much guaranteed that level up now. I think the boss itself gives like 200 XP at least. And then the crystal will fill up the level after that, and then I'll be a max character. This'll do it. That'll be handy for the boss. Oh yeah. One-shotting the crimsons now. I think I'm getting close. Oh yeah, this is definitely close. All right, come get it. It's like I'm playing an MLP DeviantArt OC in like video game form. Hopefully I have a... Oh shit! Getting hit while in cutscene mode. I hope I have all the magic I need though to finish this dungeon. This might be the one where. Yeah, I need to cast Fairy. I don't have enough magic to clear this. I'm gonna have to get to that room and then die. At least dying won't be too difficult. Okay, this is the place to die. Oh, those tiles are giving me a headache. The way they, like, almost vibrate as I walk down the path. Ugly dungeon. Okay, I think this is it. Yup. Okay. Actually do the downward thrust on him. I shouldn't have tried that. It's okay, I have plenty of lives. This is a weird hitbox. Whoa. One more. Gotcha. Not too difficult of a dungeon. The only thing that's hard about this dungeon is how hard it is to look at. Max level.
I will teach you the most powerful magic.
Okay. All spells, max level. I have 5 dolls, so that means I can have up to 5 lives each game over. I think I'm ready to storm the Great Palace. Thank you. Don't remember any of these houses having anything, but... figured it might be worth checking, in case Redux added anything. Yeah, where is that last heart? I should look for that. I'm pretty sure it's hidden somewhere in, like, the grass. I could look up a map real quick. I don't think any of these buildings are gonna have anything. Trying to game over sooner so that I can get full lives when I get to the Great Palace. Oh. Although I should look for that heart first. And I'm gonna get to the Great Palace before I actually finish game overing. Alright, so let's see. Zelda to heart locations. Let's see where that last one is. Apparently, there's one down there. Where's that? That's definitely one I haven't gotten. East of Three Eye Rock. Get the flute and play it there. I'm just gonna play it safe. Yep, that's exactly what I was looking at. It's like around here. Oh, I didn't even have to play the flute. Okay, now I'm perfectly maxed. I could go on a doll hunt too, but nah. I've already got a bigger advantage than I've ever had going into the Great Palace with the doll upgrades that I've already gotten. Alright, I'm gonna play it safe getting there now. Oh, 15% battery. Cheap some of these are now. Jump is only 4. Fuck you. And he just kills himself. Gotta hand it to them, they have dedicated themselves to serving Ganon. Fucking bullshit. God, the fucking enemy movement patterns are so bad in this game. I didn't consider the, path to level 9. Or whatever, level 7. The Great Palace. I didn't consider the road getting there. I shouldn't have suicided when I did earlier. At least if my XP bar fills up, I get an extra life. It won't be a permanent upgrade like the dolls. But any lives I lose getting there, I could probably get back while I'm in the dungeon. You know what I should do after I beat this game? I should, oh, I don't know if I'll be able to, though. New Game Plus, don't you keep all your items and stuff? Because I'm thinking something I should try doing is that old glitch with the fairy. I've never actually done it. I just know of it. Okay. You might be right. Balls! Fucking May, man. Thank you. Yeah, this leads to the Great Palace. Getting there is a real fucking gauntlet. I know what I'll do. In case the, I'm pretty sure you're right, you just keep your levels in New Game Plus, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make a save state so we can check the glitch out. I'll make it at the, outside the Great Palace. File, save state, save as. Okay, made a save state. 3 lives. So, Redux actually changes how Great Palace works. You don't have to go on a set path anymore. It's just branching paths, get there however you wish. You keep all of your spells and levels, you only lose your items. Okay. I would need my items in order to get to the town where you did the glitch, so... because it's in the town where the, rooftops you can hop on. This entire path is a dead end. Oh damn, 5% levels. Battery on my phone. Here, I'm gonna change my setup a little bit so I don't lose you guys. Thank you. Oh, that was bullshit. Chaser. There was dots in here before. At the time it was dragon heads. Maybe I'm not where I thought I was, because this room's completely different. I'm starting to think maybe there's randomized enemies, but... Right after the pillar jump. Okay. I didn't register my jump, I guess. Good, yes, fall, thank you. Get out of my way. Oh, that's cool. What a fucking asshole. All the secrets there. Oh no, not these guys. Thank you. think I'm getting close. I say that before falling into a pit that takes me to the beginning.
Yo!
You know you've caught a quality enemy when it kills the frame rates. You're not worth it.
10 XP.
Oh no 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 no!
Shit. What an asshole! Fuck you! That doesn't work on him. Okay. Oh, this enemy can suck my dick. Well, I'm back to 5 lives at least. I was getting close to.
Great, shield doesn't work on that.
Yep. Oh, don't tease me like that, game. have a heart. Please have a potion. Oh, okay. Okay, okay. Nice. Stuck in the wall floor. Oh boy, that's a fun enemy. There's gold versions of them too that were never used. Follow me now, Dick Bird. Those fuckers will hunt you. Say, still at 4 lives, full health, full magic. And I'm getting close, I think. Yep. Yep, I'm real close. I think I go this way, I walk across a crumbling bridge at some point, and I fall down a hole. I might be thinking of a different dungeon that I already did. Oh, they really like this enemy, don't they? Okay, okay. Look at that, he perfectly hunts you. Ooh. Am I going to cheese the final boss or do it like a man? I guess it really depends on how many lives I have left by the time I get there. If I'm down to one life and that means I'm gonna end up having to restart the whole dungeon, then I'm probably gonna cheese it, yeah. I mean, I still have three lives, so far so good. My cat's being a real shithead. Oh my god, fuck this thing! Why won't the block break? God damn! I hate this fucking bird thing. I hate him. You can't hit him for shit. And he just follows you the whole way. Oh boy. Worst video game enemy ever. Worst video game ever. That's so fucking bullshit. They just track you. Always hated them. And again, to think that there's a gold version that never got used in the game, that would have been, like, even harder. It would have done, like, more damage to you and hit harder. Okay, I don't think he's gonna be able to follow me now. Fucker. Unlike the Dark Nuts, you can't do, like, the jump and slash trick. It just doesn't seem to work on them. Like, sometimes it does if you get really lucky, but... yeah, they're pretty fucking hard. Here's a crimson one. Oh god, run. Thank you. I bet you there's gonna be another one of those blue birds around the corner here. Okay. Oh, good. Fuck you. I don't know, I think I'm gonna have to cheese Darklink. Definitely gonna have to. Really hope I'm going the right way. Let me guess, this is gonna lead to a dead end. Yep. Level designers are bastards. Only fairies gave magic, too. Oh, well. That helps. And if everything really goes down the toilet, like that. At least I have an upgrade to my max lives. Cool. I might look up a map of the palace if I game over. I think that might be a wise idea. Oh, you know what? What's the point in going to the supply room if I've already got full? Like this whole time I've just been going in circles. So many rooms that just look the same, with maybe a couple different enemies. What is your fetish with this enemy? Death seems pretty inevitable right now. I may as well just let that little punk kill me. I only have one life left. And I'm sure as hell not gonna kill the Thunderbird like this. I'm gonna get a map. Great Palace map. Map doesn't really help much if you're just gonna design it for ants. Okay, here we go. Okay, down, left, left, down. Right all the way, down all the way, right all the way, down all the way. Okay. You know what? I've got to figure out a way to... Ah, fuck it. I'm just gonna pause frequently and take a look, make sure I don't screw up here. Okay, so for the entrance, go left one, down one. Look at that, 6 max lives. Things are looking a little better now, at least. I'll just follow the map, make my way there. Put an end to this. Okay, so left one. Yeah, you go right across a lava bridge. Pillars, go down one, right one, down all the way. That's the block room, and then I'm gonna go in here, and there's gonna be a down elevator on the right, after passing some lava, it looks like. Oh, fucking suck my ass. Down as far as I can. And then I go right down. I don't have to worry about all the looping paths, since the mod does away with that, so I'm gonna ignore the letters. Room should be lava. I'm probably going to die in here. It's gonna be one of those asshole blue dudes, I think. Yep, there he is. This is the part where I die. Unavoidable death here. Yeah. Problem is, there's just too many rooms. I was very close, but I took a wrong turn at some point. Like, I took a left when I should have took a right, by the looks of it. I fucking hate you. Okay, lava bridge here. So that puts me here, I think. So I'm gonna go across, there'll be a down elevator that leads to a room with curtains. Yeah, there was a point where I left this area. I went back left from there, so I was really close. I was really, really close. I took a wrong turn. Oh, that's frustrating. Look at seeing how close I was. Yep, this room again. Okay. So there's like an endless path here. Secret room. Oh my god, I was so close. I had to go down all the way. Left one, down one. Right one. And then there's the hole you drop down, and then that leads to the boss area. I was so close. I took a wrong turn, and it just fucked me. Damn. I could have gotten there with like 3 lives. Yeah, this is the hardest Zelda game. People consider it that for a reason. This is the Zelda game that was supposed to get people to buy Nintendo Power. Okay, just to make sure I'm supposed to go down here, left. And then I break down there and fall. It's cryptic, the enemies are difficult. It's rough. Very rough. Okay, there's a secret hole hidden underneath these. This is where I got turned around. This is what I was missing. You have to do that. That's the only way. I'm not kidding you. That is a requirement. It is the only path to get down here. That's what I missed. I walked over that room like 2 or 3 times. Okay, if I go left, there should be supplies. I am like 3 rooms away from the boss. I like this game, but it's got issues. It's got some glaring issues, and I'm willing to admit that. Game should have had a map would have helped this game a lot. Like, it should have had a map like Zelda 1 had. So, annoying thing about this room, I can't remember which it is, but one of the blocks has a chance of dropping a potion. Nothing. Alright. I still have 5 lives, so I'm all set anyways. I'm gonna try to fight Dark Link legit. Okay, this is the room I was thinking of. Balls, balls, balls. I think I go right from here. Okay, there is a storage room to the left. I'm not gonna bother. Okay, here we go. Thunderbird. Yeah, I went in there with low health. No magic. That's okay. Now, if I game over after killing the Thunderbird will stay dead. So there is that. Not what I meant to use. Really distracting me with his table rattling. I'm ready to throw him out. It was one hit away. Cat, are you not clean enough already? I'm not gonna survive this. So hard to predict his movements. Got you, fucker. I have two lives left, so I'm gonna give one legit shot at Dark Link. If I had a full life to do it, I could probably do it, but I don't want to risk getting game over here. Let's do it. I just need shield anyways, and then the rest can be spent on healing. Thank you. Yeah, fuck this. Shitty boss. Fuck you. Wow, you fucking suck, dude. Yeah, that's what I thought. Fuck you. The gnome? It's the wise old man from the first game. It gives you your sword. You saved Hyrule. And you are a real hero.
This is delicious!
Boy, I love this game, but it will chew you up, it'll spit you out, and then it'll use you as a butt plug. This was talked about earlier, but this game gives you a new game plus where you start with all your levels and spells. But yeah, we talked about that earlier. I'm gonna go ahead and load that save state, and let's see if that glitch still works. Wait, what? Hang on. Save state, load state from... Here we go. Okay, back here. I'm just gonna go ahead and game over on purpose so that I can get to where I want to be faster. And this will be where I end the night. The next old Zelda I play will be Link to the Past. A lot of people love that one. It's not my personal favorite. I think it's an okay game. I didn't have a good first experience with it. I mentioned before, I didn't understand how the Dark World and Light World were different, and I found navigating the overworld to be difficult because of it. Now I have a better understanding of how that works, though, and I think I'd have a better time playing it. Okay, I need to figure out what that one village was where you jump on the rooftops, because that's where you do the glitch. I think it's this one. Yeah, it looks like it. I might be wrong, though. Yeah, I'm not seeing any chimneys. There's that, but that's not gonna get me high enough, I don't think. Wind Waker will be the next game I play. after Hyrule Warriors, of course, which is going to be very soon, because I might actually download the demo tomorrow and check it out. It'll be soon. I'm going to check out Age of Calamity very soon. I'll definitely check out the demo before it releases, because I'm actually getting impatient. I think this might be it. Here, why don't I, just look it up. Zelda 'Town is the one with the chimneys. That's what I'm looking for. Pretty sure it was before this area, because I didn't go down this area until today, I don't think. Hang on. Zelda to Chimney. Darunia Town. Darunia, that's the one north of... Yeah, I'm not going the right way. Yeah, it's north of this area. I go through the cave. Okay, okay. I know where I'm going. And I'm gonna get stopped on by every single enemy in the game on the way there. Okay. I go up here. The best part is glitch isn't even gonna be worth the time that we spend trying to get to it. It's just a dumb little party gag. Even worse, watch, it'll turn that the Redux fixed the glitch. That'd be really lame if they did. Fixing fun little glitches. What you want to do is you want to get up here, select the fairy spell, and jump up, and while you're out of bounds... Yeah! Well, what? That's not what it's supposed to do? It's supposed to do... Wait a minute. I'm wondering. Is this like a fake town? What happens if I leave? This is it. That was a fake town. So I can't move. And this is how the game ends. This is Link's fate. He saves Zelda, and he sets sail, and Link's Awakening happens. So there you go. sometime this week I'm going to download the Age of Calamity demo, and I'll check that out. For now, though, I'm going to cut the stream here. I got to work on getting these VODs up. I have all three Zelda 2 VODs ready to go up.